This video tutorial I will explain using a Spring Boot application how to send a JSON object into Kafka topic and using Spring Boot application how to consume a JSON object from Kafka topic. Here you can see Apache Kafka ecosystem and here you can see Kafka cluster. It has brokers. Each broker has topics and here you can see Spring Boot application. The Spring Boot application name is Spring Boot Kafka producer demo. And here you can see the REST client. In this example, we will use Postman as REST client, which will send JSON object to this Spring Boot application. And it has producer code. Using that, it will send JSON object to Kafka topic. And here you can see Spring Boot application. The Spring Boot application name is Spring Boot Kafka consumer demo. It has a consumer code. Using that, it will consume a JSON object from Kafka topic. We will see this example. Here you can see two eclipses. In first eclipse, it has a Spring Boot Kafka producer demo application. And in the second eclipse, it has a Spring Boot Kafka consumer demo application. First, we will see Spring Boot Kafka producer demo. Here you can see Spring Boot Kafka producer demo application and its folder structure. And here you can see pom.xml file. And in pom.xml file, I have included the dependencies of Spring Boot Starter, Spring Boot Starter Web, Spring Kafka. Here I have defined the class animal. It has three properties: name, color and animal type. And getter and setter methods for these properties and toString method. And this is the model class. Here I have defined a class Kafka producer config, which is a configuration class. And it has two methods: producer factory and Kafka template. And this method returns producer factory object with key type string, value type is animal. And this method returns Kafka template object with key type string and value type animal. Here I have defined the map config props and here I have specified key as bootstrap server config, which is nothing but Kafka server IP address and port number. And key serializer class config and value serializer class config. When Spring Boot application starts, this producer factory method and Kafka template methods will be called by Spring Boot container and it will create a producer factory object and Kafka template object based on these configurations, and those objects will be ready for further usage. Here I have defined the class Kafka producer service, which is a service class, and here I have auto wired Kafka template object. Here I have defined the topic name as animal topic, and it has a send message method which accept animal object. Using send method of Kafka template object, I am sending animal object to animal topic. Here I have defined the class Kafka message controller, which is REST controller. And here I have auto wired Kafka producer service object. It has publish message method, which accept animal object. To call this method, we have to use this URI. Slash publish. And here I am calling a send message method of Kafka producer service object to send animal object to Kafka topic. Then I am displaying this information and also it returns successfully published animal equal to the particular animal object details to the animal topic. In application.properties file, server port I have mentioned as 9090. So when Spring Boot application starts, it will use 9090 port. Here I have defined a class Kafka producer demo application, which is a Spring Boot application. Using this, we can start this Spring Boot application in 9090 port. Before start this Spring Boot application, I will start Zookeeper, Kafka server, then I will start this particular Spring Boot application. First, I will start the Zookeeper server, copy this command. Zookeeper server has been started. Next, I am going to start Kafka server. Copy this command. Kafka server has been started. Next, I am going to create animal topic. And here you can see animal topic has been created. Now I am going to start Kafka producer demo application. And the Kafka producer demo application has been started in 9090 port. Here you can see Spring Boot Kafka consumer demo application. Here you can see the folder structure, and here you can see the pom.xml file. In pom.xml file, I have included the dependency of Spring Boot Starter, Spring Boot Starter Web, Spring Kafka. Here I have defined the class animal. It has three properties: name, color and animal type, and getter and setter methods for these three properties, and toString method. And one important point is, we have to make sure this animal class package is same as Spring Boot Kafka producer demo animal package. And also we have to make sure these properties are same in both producer side and consumer side. Here I have defined the class Kafka consumer config, which is a configuration class. Here I have defined the group ID as group 100, and it has two methods, consumer factory and animal listener. In this method, I am creating a config map and adding configurations like bootstrap server config, which is nothing but Kafka server IP address and port number, group ID config, key deserializer class config, value deserializer class config. And this method returns consumer factory object with key type string and value type animal. And this method returns concurrent Kafka listener container factory object with key type string and value type animal. And when Spring Boot application starts, the Spring Boot container will call this consumer factory method and animal listener method, and creates a consumer factory object and concurrent Kafka listener container factory object, and make sure these two objects are ready for further usage. Here I have defined a class Kafka consumer service, which is a service class, and it has a listen method which accept animal object. In this method, I have applied Kafka listener annotation. Topic I have mentioned as animal topic. Group ID as group 100 and container factory as animal listener. This is nothing but this one. And whenever animal topic has animal object, this method will consume and it will display this information. Here I have defined a class Kafka consumer demo application, which is Spring Boot application. Now I am going to start this Spring Boot application. And this consumer application has been started in 8080 port. Here you can see. I have started Kafka server, Spring Boot Kafka producer demo application and Spring Boot Kafka consumer demo application. Now I am going to use Postman, which is a REST client, and going to send animal details as a JSON object to Spring Boot Kafka producer demo application. Now I am going to open Postman client. And I am going to send request to this particular URL, http://localhost, port number of producer application is 9090. Then I am going to send request to this particular publish URI. Then http method is post. Here we have to select body and raw and select JSON. And here I am sending the animal details in the payload. Name is lion, color is orange brown, animal type is wild animal. Click on send. And here we got the response. Successfully published animal, that animal details are here to the animal topic. This message we got from the producer application and status code is 200 OK. And this is the producer log. Successfully published animal, that animal details are here to the animal topic. Now we will see the consumer log, and here you can see the consumer log. Received animal, that animal details are here from the animal topic. Now I am going to send one more animal details. Name is cat, color is white, and animal type is domestic animal. Left side producer log is there, clear that. Right side consumer log is there, clear that. Click on send. And we got 200 OK, which is successful. And here you can see the producer log. Successfully published animal. The animal name is cat, color is white, and animal type is domestic animal to the animal topic. And right side consumer log is there. Received animal, the animal name is cat, color is white, animal type is domestic animal from the animal topic.
You can get a Java source code link for each video from the description section of the video. And here you can see the video. And to see the description, click on this more. And here you can see the description. And here you can see the links. And click on these links to get the Java source code.